Hey, what's up guys, Damian here, and this video is gonna be your ultimate ability card guide version 2. And the first video was way back in January, and of course a lot of things have been changed since then. Cards have been tweaked and new cards have been added to the game, and we're gonna talk about all those things in this video. But first things first, we have to talk about the changes. So the Deadeye drain has been increased when you activate Deadeye for every single card, and this was done because players had the habit of using Deadeye for every single kill, and that is especially true with Painted Black, which has also seen an increase to its Deadeye drain per shot. And of course that was a very cheesy tactic. I mean, you could exploit Deadeye, especially with Painted Black, in order to get the easier kills with pinpoint accuracy, and clearly Rockstar doesn't want us to do that anymore. I mean, you can still do it, but it's gonna ultimately cost you in tonics and in money. So from now on, Painted Black, it is considered nerfed, but it still functions the same. I mean, the shotguns are the same, the bow is the same, and you can still flick in and out and shoot with the repeaters and the rifles. So yeah, if you wanna keep doing this tactic, it's gonna cost you now with this nerf. Slow and steady has seen an damage reduction. The damage reduction have been increased, which means that now you can absorb more shots, so slow and steady has been buffed. But from what I've tested, there seems to be still that thing where slow and steady needs a couple of seconds in order to fully apply, and if you get shot in between those 2 seconds, the normal damage will be applied to you, even though you are technically in slow and steady. So I don't know if that's a bug or if that's the way they intended slow and steady to be, but that's how it is right now, guys. And now we have the biggest surprise change of the entire update, the Slippery Bastard nerf. And now you don't have to free aim the enemy. You can lock on to Slippery Bastard users, but your shots will be very inaccurate, and of course also both your shots and the enemy shots are gonna be very inaccurate. But that's no problem for Painted Black, of course, which is now easier to counter Slippery Bastard with Painted Black, because at least previously you had to free paint the target, but now you can lock on paint the Slippery Bastard user. And so this card is next to useless, guys, unfortunately. Now if you come across a Painted Black user, which is pretty much everybody, you are as good as dead. And previously I didn't use Slippery Bastard, I'm not gonna use it now, obviously. So yeah. Okay, now moving on to the combat abilities. The first new card is Gunslinger Choice. When dual wielding, you deal much more damage and you are much more accurate. So this card sounds good, but in theory it isn't, simply because PvP is dominated by carbines, repeaters, rifles and shotguns. So if you bring dual pistols into the fight, you're more likely to lose. And the only ideal situation for Gunslinger Choice, in my opinion, is if you're playing the sidearms challenge free roam event. And other than that, I cannot really see a very beneficial situation for Gunslinger's Choice. And I've also tested it with Slippery Bastard to see if it kind of compensates for the inaccuracy that Slippery Bastard now has. And no, guys, unfortunately, it's very inaccurate. Still, there is no change whatsoever. And I've even tested it with the sound of shotguns, and also the shotguns of the Lemat revolvers, and they are still, I mean, horribly inaccurate. They go all over the place, and the entire shotgun pattern goes elsewhere, and unfortunately the Gunslinger Choice does not help with Slippery Bastard. Okay, now we have sharpshooter. While using a scope, you deal much more damage and take much less damage. This is an excellent card for the sniper, obviously, because you're gonna use the sniper scopes and you don't really wanna use the other scopes of the other weapons, even though you can still get the one-shot headshot with every weapon that has a scope with the new headshot mechanics. And this is a very good card if you are doing sniper duels, because it also gives you much less damage reduction, you take less damage. So in my opinion, this is a must-have for sniper duels, and you can use it, of course, in general if you are sniping. Okay, now the Hangman card. Previously did not work at all, it did not give you any damage, and now it gives you a fixed amount of damage, but still, guys, this is a useless card. I mean, you're not gonna use it against players, and if you wanna do bounty hunting and you wanna lasso the target, you don't want to choke them to death, obviously. I mean, you wanna capture them alive. So I don't know what the purpose of this card is. I mean, it's completely useless. It won't help in any situation, really, and they might as well remove this card. Okay, winning streak has been buffed. Now the damage bonus ends if the target is not shot for 10 seconds, and previously it was only for 2 seconds. So that is a great improvement for a winning streak. Okay, now moving on to the recovery abilities. The first new card is Iron Lung. Your stamina regenerates faster and you take much less damage depending on your current stamina level. This is an excellent card for those who like to run and gun, and if you wanna be able to take a couple more shots before going down, this is an excellent card for you. But keep in mind that your stamina needs to be less than full in order for the bonus, the damage reduction boost, to apply. So this means that it is for running and gunning. Second new card for the recovery abilities is Kick in the Butt. Whenever you take damage, a large proportion of it is added to your Deadeye. And this is a Deadeye restoration card, but unfortunately it involves you getting shot at, and it works for every card except Slow and Steady. And that's because for Slow and Steady, it compensates for the Deadeye penalty that Slow and Steady has. You know, if you get shot while in Slow and Steady, you also lose a small portion of your Deadeye as well. So this card basically negates the Deadeye damage perfectly, and you don't take any damage to your Deadeye at all with this card. So I think this was made specifically to counter Slow and Steady's weakness, and you might consider it using this card if you are going for a Slow and Steady loadout. And if you're not in Deadeye and the enemy kills you with one shot and you have 100% health, you will restore roughly about 20% of your Deadeye when you respawn back in. Okay, now the third card for the recovery abilities is Live for the Fight. You regenerate Deadeye slowly over time, and at first, guys, I was very enthusiastic that they finally, you know, they added a Deadeye card that is able to regenerate Deadeye slowly over time. But here's the thing, it's very slow, guys, and it will take forever to regenerate a full Deadeye ring, and I do not recommend this guard, guys, at all. Of course, in PvP, it's useless, you will not see any difference. Maybe you wanna use this if you are free roaming and you're not really using Deadeye. I mean, if you are maybe a new player who doesn't have tonics and, you know, he cannot afford to buy snake oil, stuff like that, maybe that's the card for you. But still, I mean, the cost you have to pay for upgrading this card, you know, you might as well buy the tonics, I mean, with the $900. And the effects of this card need to be quadrupled in order to make it useful. Okay, Ride Like the Wind. Whenever you take or deal damage while mounted, a large proportion of it is added to your horse's health and stamina. So basically, this is like Strange Medicine, but for the horse. It doesn't have a penalty like you know, the Strange Medicine has, and it is also applied for the stamina of the horse as well. And now the only situation I can think of where this card might come in handy is if you want to rush in a group of NPCs, you know, because the NPCs are inaccurate and they try to hit you, but they always end up hitting your horse. So while you're hitting them, you are basically regenerate health for, and stamina for your horse, and that will keep the horse alive, and you will be able, you know, to move around the group of NPCs and take them out one by one. And if that's your playstyle, then this card is for you. The Eye for an Eye card hasn't seen a change, but it has been indirectly nerfed due to the new headshot mechanic. So if you are at further range, as you know, you're gonna have to two-shot headshot the enemy in order to kill him. So if you have this card, you need to put up double the effort in order to get the Dead Eye restoration bonus. The Gift of Focus, they've removed the penalty from this card, the damage penalty, and they did good because it was completely unnecessary penalty to have. But still, this card is not very useful because the effects of this card are not very noticeable really, and I think they need to buff the effects of this card, guys, in order to make it more viable. Okay, now moving on to the defensive abilities. The first new card is Fool Me Once. You take much less damage each consecutive time you are shot. This effect ends if you are not shot for 10 seconds. Now this card, guys, is similar to Winning Streak, but you don't have to get shot from the save enemy. Of course, this is much better for this card. You can absorb a lot more hits and from different enemies. And of course, Winning Streak can balance this card. I mean, if you have Winning Streak and the enemy has this card, you will do the normal damage. But this card, guys, can really keep you alive. This is a very good defensive card because if you are using Tonics and if you're using Slow and Steady as well, you can survive a lot of shots, guys. You can survive shotgun blasts, sniper rounds, explosive rounds even. And this is a great card if you're going for a tanky setup, and I highly recommend you absolutely upgrading this card to the max, trying it out, and this might be the next meta card when we're talking about you know, defensive builds, tank builds. So this card is a good one, guys, I highly recommend this. Friends for Life, while mounted, you and your horse take much less damage, and this is a very self-explanatory card. You wanna use this for every horse-related activity, such as horse races or the Horseback Kills Challenge free roam event. And obviously this will help you and your horse stay alive for longer. And you can combine this card with Ride Like the Wind, with Strange Medicine, in order to further, you know, keep you alive and your horse. Strength in Numbers, you take much less damage for every nearby ally, up to a maximum of 3 allies. And this is obviously a team-oriented defensive card. If you have friends in your posse, you might as well consider using this card in order to boost your defense. And I would recommend you use it if you have more than 3 friends, in case somebody dies, the next guy can replace him, so you always keep your defensive boost up. And I've also tested the maximum activation and deactivation radius of this card, and the results were very weird, because as I was moving away from my teammate, it took 25 steps for this card to deactivate, but when I started taking steps back, it did not reactivate again, and that was very weird. So I kept walking and I had to do 8 steps in order to make it active again. So it will take 17 steps towards the teammate in order for this card to reactivate it. And that was very confusing, and I think they did this to keep you know, the posse closer, and in case somebody wanders off, he has to do extra steps in order to get this card activated again. So maybe this was done to keep the teammates closer together. And that's what my test showed. That was the results, guys. I know it sounds weird, and it is weird, really. And when I started walking, I was right next to my teammate. I wasn't in front of him or behind him. And the tests were done with the default walking style and on flat ground. Hunker down has been buffed actually. Now you take even much less damage while in cover, so you can survive more shots. And now with the new cover mechanics, and if the enemy locks onto you and you go in cover, the lock on will break faster and they will lose track of you. And so this card has been buffed directly and indirectly, you know, because of the new mechanics. And if you are the tactical type of player, you might as well consider using this card. And finally, we have a few changes with the Never Without One card. The arrows will now penetrate the hat, so it's always a one-shot headshot kill with a bow and arrow. That's the one change. And the second change, guys, is that now you can pick your hat back up in showdowns. But that didn't always happen, and sometimes, you know, I could pick up my hat back up, sometimes I couldn't. So I looked into it, I further investigated it, and I found out that if it is a headshot that is blocked by the hat, then the hat despawns and you cannot find it. And only if it is a hat shot, you can pick it back up. But you have to find the hat physically, it won't show up on the minimap. The hat icon will not show. So if you're wearing one of those big fancy hats with a feather, it will be easier for you to find your hat. So hat choice matters as well now with Never Without One. And that were the two basic changes, the important changes. And of course now Never Without One also benefits from the new headshot mechanics, because if you get shot from range in the face, you will not die, and they will also do less damage compared to if you're not wearing the Never Without One card. And of course you will keep your hat, it will not fall off your head. So those are the three new things about Never Without One. Now you know everything about this card, and it is a fairly balanced card. You cannot say that it was overpowered like it was when the game first launched, which gave you complete protection over your head. And now, you know, some people might liked it before, some people might like it now, but that's how things are. And that concludes your ultimate ability card guide video, guys. Thanks for staying with me that long. This is your most complete guide on the internet right now. So yeah, thanks for watching this video, guys. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.